Raj Chaudhary, Sri Abhay Kumar Srisrimal, all APEX member committee members, the chairpersons of the various chapters, JITO chapters of India and abroad, and the chairperson of the Chennai JITO committee, Mr. Dolat Jain, and other members of the Chennai chapter, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to you all. It is indeed a great pleasure for me, great honor as well, to be with you this morning. And I wish to thank the Jain International Trade Organization for inviting me to address this distinguished audience on the occasion of the JBN 360 Program 2020. Allow me at the very outset to express my sincere appreciation to JITO Chennai chapter for giving me the opportunity to talk about Mauritius and to share with you the plethora of trade and investment opportunities that Mauritius offers. Ladies and gentlemen, I must say that since its independence in 1968, Mauritius has emerged, despite the odds initially militating against it, as a robust and successful economy. In fact, Mauritius made a remarkable progress in boosting its socio-economic development agenda and has evolved from a monocrop economy of 1960s to becoming a multi-pillar economy today. The reasons are not far to seek. The economic success of Mauritius has predominantly been due to its prevailing political and social stability. Strong democratic principles and values, the rule of law, and a clear vision of our political leaders to adopt a pro-growth and development agenda. This has contributed to the growing reputation of Mauritius as a stable, reliable, and competitive investment hub. The Mauritius economy continues its steady expansion with a real GDP growth estimated at 3.6% in 2019. In fact, we are projecting a steady GDP growth rate for the years ahead. This is an expected outcome in line with the new strategic vision of the government to develop Mauritius into a vibrant economy